equally. So welcome to my beginner's class Pilates. So if you're new to Pilates, this is what it's all about. It's all about posture. It's all about thinking about your core. It's all about strength and mobility. So Joseph Pilates invented this quite a long time ago now. In the First World War, he was interned in a British prisoner of war camp, and there he decided he needed to help other prisoners look after their bodies. Not only look after their bodies physically, but also look after their bodies from a mental health point of view as well. He was very interested in people's posture and how to help people realign their posture. So, the start of a Pilates is always about setting your body up into a good alignment so you have a good posture and hold your spine in neutral. So let's get going with that. First of all, I want us to look down and think about our feet. We need to think about standing with our feet firmly placed on the mat, hip distance apart. If you find getting your feet hip distance apart quite complicated, an easy way to do this, stand with your feet together. Move your feet apart with your toes and then bring your heels out to match. Now let's think about standing up nice and tall. Imagine you've got a lovely golden thread that's taking your head straight up to the ceiling. Your eyes looking out to the horizon. Your shoulders are nice and relaxed. So they shouldn't be up by your ears, they should be nicely down your back. Imagine you're sliding your shoulder blades down into your back pockets. Now let's think about standing up nice and tall with that neutral spine. Remember, our spine's got a nice little curve to it. So to enable us to stand in this lovely posture, we want to think about our pelvis. Imagine your pelvis is a little shallow bowl of water, and by rocking your pelvis backwards and forwards, you can slosh the water in and out. I'm going to turn around to the side so you can see this more clearly. So we rock our pelvis forwards and backwards, tilting it forwards and backwards, until we finally get to a position where we're not sloshing that water around anymore and we're in a nice neutral spine. Our shoulders are nicely down our back, we're nice and relaxed, we haven't locked out our knees. Now let's just finally think about the breathing. Breathing is really important in Pilates. It slows the movement down and it enables us to really relax into the exercises. Place your fingers on your ribs, take a nice deep breath in. Feel that chest expand and your fingers will start moving outwards. Breathe out, in other words, exhale, and your fingers will join up again. Let's try that once more. Beautiful. I think we're ready to begin. So to start with, let's take a nice deep breath in and let's engage our core. What do I mean by engaging our core? Well, imagine we've got a very wide belt all the way around us and we've tightened that belt in so much so that we literally can't breathe. Now slowly let that belt loosen and just have it tightened up to about 20 to 30%. This is how we hold our body throughout the exercises in Pilates. Now let's get going with a little bit of warm up. So we're going to warm up our muscles and we're going to mobilize those joints. So let's just start off moving our right shoulder and rolling it backwards. And now let's get that left shoulder involved. Moving it backwards, getting that nice rotation happening, nice mobility in the shoulder. Now let's go both together. You may hear some little crunching and cracking. That's your bones just trying to find their place within your connective tissue. And now let's go into our elbows. One elbow, just circulating around that shoulder, followed by the other one. And finally, let's go to the whole arm. So let's do some nice arm circles. Onto the left arm, nice arm circles, really big movement. And then let's move both together. Good. And now what we're going to do is we can get a little bit of movement of our whole body moving our arms down, bending our knees, so we're getting some movement in those nice knee joints. And now take the arms up, and I just want you to raise the arms up towards the ceiling. Just a few times on each side. And then arms coming down to the front, same thing. Move them out away from that shoulder joint. And let's do an exercise that we call the archer. So imagine you're pulling back a bow with the arrow in it. We look round behind us at the same time, and then we slowly come forward again. So pull back, follow through, looking behind you, come to the front again. And once more, back and to the front, back, slowly to the front. Good. Now let's go up again. This time, I want you to come up onto one toe as you come up with your arm. So it's a movement of the body as well as the arm. And then come up onto both toes, arms raised towards the ceiling, nice balance. And then slowly come down. Once again, come up onto your toes, a nice balance, and then slowly down. Now let's do some nice squats. So let's just bend those knees. Imagine you're sitting down on a chair. Those knees should be going directly towards and over your ankles. Lovely. And then let's do some nice gentle knee lifts. So we're moving that hip joint, getting some movement there, nice and gentle. And then from here, we're gonna do some nice rotation around the hip. So rotate out, once more, and then we go to the left side. So hip coming up, and then rotate out, good. Lovely. And then finally, let's get a little bit of bend down towards the side of our spine. So nice and slow. Imagine you've got a pane of glass in front of you and behind you, so you can't go forward or backwards. Slowly coming down to the side. Good. And now we're just going to do one final balance. So again, balancing is a really key thing to maintaining your posture. So remember those knee lifts we did. So prepare yourself, just come up onto your toe, slowly bring that knee up, and then slowly the knee comes out to the side, comes back in, and goes back down. So again, with the other leg, come up slowly onto that toe, carefully lift up, out to the side, and back in. So that's a lovely balancing. Okay, wonderful. Now I'm going to move to the end of my mat. And we're going to start with an exercise that's known as the curl down. It's all about the mobility in our spine. So imagine that all of the little vertebrae in your spine are the links of a bicycle chain. We're starting off with a lovely deep breath in. As we exhale, we slowly bring our chin down towards our chest. We're imagining that we're peeling away from a wall. We're keeping our bottom tucked in. And we're slowly heading towards the ground in a nice controlled way. We're allowing our arms to drop, our shoulders to relax. Slowly, slowly coming down. One vertebra at a time, that head is dropping, and slowly coming towards the mat. As you get down towards the mat, I want you to slowly walk your hands in front of you, coming down onto all fours. So, this exercise is all about your posture, maintain that neutral spine, so we've still got that lovely little curve in our back. We've got our wrists directly underneath our shoulders. We've got our fingers beautifully splayed out. We've got our knees directly underneath our hips. And from here, we take a deep breath in. Exhale, move the leg away from us. Just slide it along the mat, bring it back in again. Same with the other leg. Deep breath in. Exhale, move it along the mat. We're going to do six on each leg. And what we're trying to concentrate on whilst we're doing this is we're looking down at the mat. We're keeping our spine in neutral. We go in with our breath. Breathe in. Exhale on the movement. Breathe in as we come back in. And what we're trying to make sure we don't do is we don't want to be shifting our weight too much from one leg to the other. We try to keep that stability. So we're holding ourselves in at the core, and it's the core that's keeping that stability. Imagine you've got something balanced on your hips and you can't move them either side. One more on each leg. And then we're going to be moving to alternate arms and alternate legs. As one leg moves away, the other arm comes in front. We lift off the mat. We have a lovely stretch and we come back to that neutral position. We slide along the mat. At the end, we stretch, lift off, and come back. Again, we do six on each leg. We go with the breathing, so we breathe out on the movement. We breathe in as we come back. Nice and controlled. Again, remember the focus is on holding ourselves from that core, sliding away, coming back in. Think of it as a stretch away with a lift right at the end. Keep it nice and slow, keep it controlled. Go with the breathing. One more on each side. And from here, we're going to do a release stretch. So we're going into what's known as child's pose. So bring your feet together, knees apart, and you just try and sit back onto your heels and have a lovely stretch. Remember to breathe nice and deeply. Releasing out through that back. Beautiful. Now the final exercise we can do is all about your back again. It's about strengthening and getting some good mobility in the back. So we're coming down onto our fronts. We have our arms either side of the mat in a box position, 90 degrees, elbows to wrists, and our forehead is going to be nicely balanced on the floor. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. And slowly bring your chest, your neck and your head up. Inhale. Slowly come down. Exhale up. Slowly down, inhale. Exhale up, remembering it's only the top half of our body that's moving. Our bottom muscles are nice and loose. Our ankles and our feet are nice and relaxed. getting mobility in that spine. Do two more of these. And last one. And now we can move up a level. Exhale. As we bring our chest up, we hover our arms off the floor. Everything comes back on the inhale. Exhale, hover up. Only the top half is moving, bottom half is staying nice and still. Feet are relaxed, bottom's relaxed. Two more. Last one. And relax. Now coming up onto all fours, we're going to do what's known as a cat stretch, just to release off our back. So from that lovely neutral spine position, going to take a deep breath in. On the exhale, we round our back up into a lovely little hill. Feel that beautiful stretch in the spine and slowly back to neutral. Wonderful. There's just two basic Pilates exercises. And from here, we're just going to do a little bit of stretching. So, we're just gonna stretch that spine out again. So, sitting nice and comfortably, if we just curl down, lovely C-shaped curl. And then coming back up. Again, a nice C-shaped curl. Curling back up. And then if we slowly bring ourselves onto all fours, we're going to slowly curl ourselves back up, the opposite to as we came down to the mat. Tuck our feet under, push towards our knees, and slowly feet come down, bottoms tuck in, slowly we uncurl those vertebrae until our head is the last thing to come up. And there we have it. Bit of beginner's Pilates. Thank you very much.